Hey there, it's Tammy C. Walker, life coach, therapist, social worker. Hit subscribe and hit like for me. Today I want to talk about how to start your own business. Out of the mouth of babes. My 14-year-old niece, Deja, she texted me last night and said, Auntie, you need to add some music to your video. She said, uncopyrighted music. And you need to add more advice at the end. Talk about your life and things you've been through. Whoop, I guess she told me. And hey, I'm from the school of age ain't nothing but a number. You can be six, like my little great nephew. His name is Kim Okai. We call him all kinds of nicknames. But anyway, he told me, TT Tammy, you have a YouTube channel? He got so excited. He saw one of my videos. He said, you look tired. And so I did listen to him. I tried to look a little bit more presentable than I did, I guess, in that video, because he told me, didn't he? So anyway, someone could be age six, like Kai, or they can be 100, you know, and be able to give you positive feedback, or 14, like Deja, which I'm quite impressed, and I appreciate her for watching my videos and for her giving me solid, good advice that Auntie is taking. So, okay, about starting your own business. I began my own business as a life coach in 2010. I always reference back, beating cancer because that was pivotal in my life. And that was what created me to be who I am today. So it was after, I got better in 2008, 2009. I think most would say if they recover or when they recover from a severe illness, a serious illness, a life-changing illness or a bad accident or something, a tragedy, you start to think like, why am I here? What is my purpose? So that's what I was thinking, and which that led me to being a life coach because people would come to me for advice. Not that I had all the answers, but I think because I'm a good listener and I try to be compassionate, I try. So anyway, let's go with step number one. Number one, what is your business? Me, I knew I wanted to be a life coach, so I began researching certificates and, you know, what all does it take to become a life coach? It's not one of the hardest businesses to start. So I began doing my homework. What about you? If you're a caterer, if you are a baker, if you are a photographer, if you are a singer, songwriter, musician, a hairstylist, event planner. I could go on and on, a seamstress or a tailor or a stylist, if the sky's the limit. What is it you want to do? Study that background. Look at other people that do what you do. I'm a big fan of Les Brown. I always have been for many years. So I kind of started studying him as well as other local life coaches. I had a life coach, so I used some of the tools that she gave me to help me. So that's number one. If it means going back to school, start now. Even if you want to go back to school in 2021, start researching your schools now. It's never too soon. Plus, this stuff takes time. So get started now. What is it you want to do? That's number one. Number two, once you have nailed it and, you know, got your certificate or did your background, let's get into, you know, the business plan. Score.org is a free service. They're throughout the United States. I used them before. Free service. CEOs from other companies that have retired, willing to come out and meet with you for free and go over your business plan. They have business plan templates on the website. So score.org, that will be on my video. So number two, get your business plan together. It doesn't have to be, you know, financials and all this stuff. But the more, the better. You don't want to do anything sloppy. Do your best. But with Google and with the internet, it's so much help out here. We don't have to do this stuff alone. So that's the good news in 2019. It's an abundance of help. Library, free books, rent out the book, How to Start Your Own Business. The ones for dummies. I love those books. They are so informative. So number two, you've got your business plan and you've used the score.org information or whatever you want to use. Let's look into getting a website started. I did my own website with intuit.com. It was okay, nothing fancy, but it did the job. So you want to get your website. where people can go online and make the purchases. That's important. Or book a service or get in contact with you. Now I have a more professional website. I paid someone to do that. So that one cost me between $250 through $350 maybe. I can't even remember. But I could put that in my website too. Simple Nerds. That's who did my website, based out of California. I think I've had my website now 2 or 3 years. I'm very pleased with it. So I'll put their information and my website in my video for you, in the body of it. So you've got your website. What about your business cards? Vista Print. That's a simple one. You know what to do with your business cards. But it's so important to be able to network and pass out your information. It looks professional. So after you've done all of that, what about where is your business going to be? When I became a life coach, I went and rented an office in Forest Park, a suburb outside of Chicago, and I jumped the gun because I didn't have clients. So don't go wasting money on a space if you don't really have your business quite running or set up. Just do free stuff. I learned later after I stopped renting the office, I would go to a nice hotel. They had cubicles set up in the lobby, and I would meet clients there. It worked out really good. Even Starbucks works, but I just think Starbucks is not as private. But you'll be surprised. Get creative. Don't go spending money too soon. And last but not least, try not to rush things, because everybody wants overnight success. And if you are a caterer and you end up with 15 clients out the gate, you're going to be overwhelmed. Start with your 2 clients, your 3. Start with people, maybe people you know. If you cater good food, your business is going to blow up, because they're going to tell somebody. They're going to tell somebody. Those referrals are going to get you business. But go slow. And in the words of Toni Braxton, let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Everything's going to work out right, you know. I do a little Tony. Let it flow, baby. I love to sing to you all. But yeah, seriously, I'm singing, but I'm serious. Let it flow. We rush stuff. We want overnight success. We want overnight relationships. We want overnight weight loss. We want everything now. But slow and steady is the best pace, because you don't become overwhelmed. You don't miss anything. You learn the lesson. Again, when I say these things, I'm talking to me. I would never get on these videos and sell you hogwash. It's always stuff that I have to tell myself, that I've been told, that I'm learning, that I've learned. So I hope my various steps helped you. And if you're serious about starting your own business, pay attention to the information I put in the body of the video. It's going to be helpful things. You can do it. I don't care what your business is. There's a lot of help out here. And have faith and confidence in your business. Don't be scared. All of us are scared. What did Joyce Meyer say? Do it afraid. Do it scared. Just do it. You'll feel better about yourself living your dream. Dreams are reality. Following your purpose and your passion. Passion is what gets you out of the bed in the morning. Not going to a job you hate. That makes you throw those covers over your head. But when it's something you believe in, sweat, blood, and tears, that's what makes you hit those feet on the ground and get up, because you're going to feel inspired. Oh, my clients need me. Oh, you know, hey, I got to get this food ready for this gig. Oh, I got to play tonight. I'm playing my guitar tonight. These are the things that motivate you and get you out of bed, not the job that we hate, you know. And we work these jobs because we got bills to pay. But you work your dream. Work your dream. Please work your dream. Tammy C. Walker, life coach, therapist, social worker. Hit subscribe and like for me. Thank you so much, as always. Comments, comments, comments. How did you start your business? What business would you like to start? Can I help you with anything? You can always get in touch with me. My information is in the body of my video. And I will be glad to give out, you know, tips or things that has helped me. And you leave information to help the viewers as well. Thank you for watching. Happy business owning. Bye.